Last time Henrik Lundqvist was pulled was back on November 19th, 2010. Not something you see very often, Johnny, but what happened defensively for the New York Rangers? It wasn't all Henrik's fault.
No, not at all. You're seeing some of the rust that the shortened training camp and no exhibition games has had for the New York Rangers. Some bad reads, some bad decisions, and some bad results for the New York Rangers. On the Pittsburgh Penguins, you cannot give them the space, but here's this little bank pass to Joe Vitale. Stu Bickel gets a bad gap, starts trying to play defense heading forward. You can't do that. And then Tyler Kennedy picking up the rebound again. Clean loss on the faceoff defensive zone. You got to try to scramble that. And then again, bad change. See the guys trying to hop over. This is the Pittsburgh Penguins you're dealing with. You cannot give them any breaks. And it's just that little bit of lack of attention of detail that the Rangers showed in tonight's game that allowed the Penguins to really take advantage. Again, it's just defensive zone coverage. Brian Boyle heading to the corner. Dan Girardi stuck in behind the net. A lot of that has to do with not being game sharp, being a little tired, being down in the game. These are things that we just don't expect the New York Rangers to do, and I don't think we'll see it out of the Rangers in a couple weeks when they get a little bit more game sharp. But right now, these games count, and they count for the Rangers, and that's a divisional opponent that they don't want to lose home ice to. They all are very important, and you just see that lack of cohesion, a lack of the system tightness that they had last year, and six goals against. I'm over.
What about the Pittsburgh Penguins? You look at what they did against the Philadelphia Flyers just yesterday. Less than 24 hours, they turn around. They have an offensive onslaught. They look tremendous. They switch goaltenders. Yep. Vokoun plays well. Fleury played well in Philly, where he didn't always play well. Are they that good?
They've been very good through the first two games. And you'd like to see them win two different kinds of games. And they played against Philly, had a tighter checking game, a little bit more physical. They were able to come through that. They play a little bit more wide open, get some defensive breakdowns against the Rangers. And then, of course, all that skill comes shining through. But they are that good. They have two very good lines, of course, with Malkin and Crosby, or Crosby and Malkin, however you want to go to look at it. And then that third line with Sutter and Cook and Kennedy, they're also very good. And then it's the defensive game. Fleury was sharp in game number one. Vokoun brought in to play a little bit more as a backup. Very sharp in game number two. And the defense, which sometimes gets criticized, has looked good.